Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Brain Bean here again, and today we're going to be taking a look at the headset portion of Razer's wireless peripheral suite, the Blackshark V2 Pro. Now, I've got a lot to say about this headset, but before we dive into that review, I do want to let you guys know that I am going to be hooking one of my subscribers up with one of these headsets. All the details on that giveaway are going to be at the end of the video, but for now, let's check out the Blackshark V2 Pro. Razer Blackshark V2 Pro isn't just a wireless version of Razer's Blackshark headset. They've actually thrown in quite a few improvements that really elevate this headset and turn it into a serious performer. Starting with the overall construction, the Blackshark V2 Pro looks almost identical to the Blackshark V2, just with a black on black color scheme this time around, which I personally prefer. The headset was designed to be ultra lightweight, which is why we see what essentially looks like wires holding the ear cups, but thankfully they're a lot stronger than they look. Still, I wouldn't recommend leaving this headset on the floor or anything like that. It's not flimsy, but it's certainly not a tank either. The ear cups are made of plastic, and overall the aesthetics to me aren't bad, but it's not the nicest looking headset. Thankfully, I don't have to look at it when it's on my head, so it's easy to look past. Now for me, the most important part of any gaming headset has to be the overall comfort. As somebody who spends an absurd amount of time sitting and playing video games, my biggest pet peeve is when a headset gives me sore spots. With the Blackshark, I just didn't notice this at all. I touched on earlier that it's lightweight, but I want to stress just how lightweight it is. It's 320 grams or just 0.7 pounds. Combine this with a generous amount of memory foam in the headband and ear cups, and it's easy to forget that this thing's on your head. The foam also allows people like me who wear glasses to minimize the pressure points that usually come with wearing a headset, which is nice. The padding is wrapped in a soft cloth material that I personally prefer over leatherette because I find that it's a little bit more breathable and prevents that swampy feeling that you can get over a long gaming session. Even with the cloth wrapping, I found that the foam helps keep things cool too, which is a nice plus. And typically I think the trade-off for leatherette is that it provides a better seal and thus more sound isolation, but the Blackshark also does a superb job at blocking out the world around you while you wear these, making it that much easier to get lost in the worlds you're exploring. And lost you will get, because the Blackshark V2 Pro, or as I like to call it, the Blackmagic V2 Pro, has some serious audio wizardry going on here. The Blackshark V2 Pro has what Razer calls their Triforce Titanium Drivers. No, not that Triforce, you nerd. Now these Triforce Titanium Drivers essentially allow you to tune the highs, mids, and lows independently, which gives you a better clarity of sound as opposed to the traditional way of tuning across the frequencies of a driver, which typically is what results in a more muddy sound.
If you've watched any of my gaming headset reviews over the years, this is something that I complain about often. A new addition to the V2 Pro is the introduction of a speaker chamber, which helps to further enhance the sound and balance it between the two ear cups. But the real game changer for me is when this technology gets combined with the THX spatial audio.
The Razer has certainly put their relationship with the audio giant to good use here, because the result is, well, it's fucking awesome. And I'll admit that personally, I am more of a DAC and set of cans guy, and I would much rather go out and purchase an absurdly expensive audio setup and use that over a traditional gaming headset. And I tell you this so that when I say that the Blackshark V2 Pro blew me away, I want you to really understand what I'm saying. Now realistically, will this provide the same audio experience as a $600 DAC and a $400 set of headphones? No, of course not. But what it does so well is provide a sound experience that really pulls you into the game.
Now currently Razer has a handful of games with specially tuned audio profiles that will kick in automatically as you play, very similar to how their Chroma integration works with games. But what's also really cool here is that you can also auto-generate the spatial audio in any game that you might play. And this is when I had my aha moment with this headset. I spent a few hours testing the headset playing Apex Legends, which does have its own THX spatial audio profile. And using it, I was taking in a game which already had a good audio profile to begin with, and enjoying the little pop-outs of footsteps and the clinking of the character's armor. But after that was done, I decided to boot up the Kingdoms of Amalur reboot for some non-working game time. And this is an older game, not exactly known for great audio or anything, but I am telling you guys, this game came alive. Streams were bubbling around me, birds were chirping, even the little tiki guys falling apart when they died rang out with this cool rain stick kind of coconut sounding effect that I had never noticed before. And I feel like this is one of those features that after you really experience it, you go back and boot up other games just to see how it changes the way that you experience the game. There's really something special happening here that takes seemingly mundane background noise and makes it come alive.
Now that said, it's not a perfect audio experience. Despite all of the efforts to increase clarity, there still is a little bit of muddiness in the mix every once in a while. Now, it's very subtle, and it's enough that I can overlook it and kind of forgive that because of how well this headset immerses you into the game.
The headset does give you some on-ear controls. On the left ear cup, there is a rather large volume knob that makes it super easy to reach for on the fly, which is nice, but I do think it's almost comically big. There's also a dedicated mute button, which gives a nice tactile click when it's activated, but I would have preferred something like an in-ear audio cue or a light that turns on when it's active or something like that, because I forget that I'm muted with this headset all the time. There's also a dedicated power button as well. The Blackshark V2 Pro also gets an updated microphone. It's what Razer calls their hyper-clear supercardioid mic. It's the largest mic that Razer's put on a headset yet, and it also features a more narrow pickup range, hence the supercardioid mic. It's a big boy, and the large windscreen doesn't do much to help its looks cosmetically. Thankfully, it is removable, so you can pop it off if you find it getting in the way when you're not using it. In terms of audio quality for a wireless mic, well, I'll just let it speak for itself.
So now I'm talking to you guys directly through the microphone on the headset. Now, if you were to plug and play this and start talking to people out of the box, you might be kind of disappointed with the microphone quality. That's because the default settings really aren't that great. But if you go into Razer Synapse and start to mess with some of the different presets or change the EQ settings on your own, you're going to notice a world of difference. Now, there are a bunch of different preset effects as well that I'll touch on a little bit later in the video, but I want you guys to let me know what you think about the quality of this microphone down in the comments below. And for those of you wondering, this is using the broadcast setting in Synapse.
In Synapse, you get a lot of control over your audio settings. You can set up your spatial audio, create your own EQ mix, or use one of the custom settings. I found that the music preset, for example, was true to its name, enhancing the music experience over the default settings, and the game mode made a pretty significant difference while in game. You also get a ton of microphone settings as well. I found that the broadcast settings sounded the best in my opinion, but you can do a lot here. You can set up a noise gate, an ambient noise filter, and a whole lot more, which does help make this headset a little bit more viable as a budget streaming option too. And I've got to admit that I was particularly impressed with just how much control you have over the microphone settings. Like the other peripherals in this wireless set, this headset is powered via Razer's Hyperspeed Wireless, which does a good job in delivering lossless audio quality, particularly on the incoming audio. Sitting at my desk using this over the course of the week, I only noticed some brief issues once or twice with the audio kind of crackling or breaking up. I was able to walk into different rooms, grab a drink, or even go into my backyard, all with no falter to the sound in my ears. Although while on calls on Discord sometimes, my mic did waver a little bit on the outgoing audio when getting pretty far away from my computer. So I would say it's like 99% lossless, but it's not perfect. The headset provides a solid 24 hours battery life, which is longer than I can go on a single session anyways, and I think realistically boils down to about a week's worth of regular use. Now, Razer, of course, provides a 6-foot charging cable, which is long enough to use while charging in a lot of cases, and you also get a 3.5mm cable here as well.
The Blackshark V2 Pro comes in at $180, and this is one of those rare times where I didn't really bat an eye at the hefty price tag. The only real negative I can mention maybe is that the lightweight construction makes it a headset that you wouldn't want to be too rough on. But that said, if you're spending almost $200 on a headset anyways, I would hope that you would take good care of it. And if I had to send this review unit back tomorrow, I would absolutely run out and spend my hard-earned cash on one of these. The THX spatial audio and the cleanliness of the sound is ultimately what won me over. And ultimately for me, what it all boils down to is the lightweight construction and the wireless freedom make this headset so liberating. The ease of use and the insane immersion in games have me grabbing this headset over my high-end audio setup way more than I ever expected. Well, that's it for the review, guys. Like I said, I do have one of these to give away to one of my subscribers. All you have to do is obviously make sure you're subscribed to this channel and hit me up in the comments section. Let me know what you think about this headset and be sure to leave your Twitter handle because I will be announcing this on my Twitter here in a couple of weeks. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, you can give it a like to show your support and be sure to follow me over on Twitter at BrainBeanGaming for that giveaway announcement. As always, guys, stay safe out there, take care of each other, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.